Where production meets artistry. Welcome to the Producer Evolution Podcast, where we talk about everything and anything music and recording related.
Hello and welcome back to the Producer Evolution Podcast. My name is Corey Snapp, and if this is your first time joining us, this is just a place where we kind of have, you know, open conversations about all things electronic music production. So today's episode, how I made $713.50 with Music Gateway. That's not to brag or anything. It's just kind of something to grab attention there. But yeah, so what is Music Gateway? It's rather unique. It's a sort of platform that offers opportunities for sync licensing as well as collaboration with others. So aside from the sync opportunities, you might see like a vocalist looking for a producer or vice versa, you know, just as an example. So in this episode, we're just going to focus on the sync licensing bit, though. I should probably point out that Music Gateway is not compensating me in any way for this podcast episode. It's just something that I thought was valuable to share with you all. Okay, so what is sync licensing? Some of you may already know this, but sync licensing is basically when you have a piece of music to go along with a visual element. So that could be a TV show, advertisement, a video game, a movie, and so on. There's a few key things that you should know. First, you have exclusive versus non-exclusive terms. Typically, you want to lean more towards non-exclusive deals, as that means that you can pursue multiple opportunities with the same piece of music. Whereas with exclusive, you're granting a single entity exclusive rights to that piece of music. This is just something that you'll have to make your best judgment call on, because there are instances where you can get extremely generous offers, you know, on an exclusive deal compared to a non-exclusive deal. So just something to keep in mind there. Another term that you want to be aware of is one stop. If you have music that you've self-released and you own all the rights to it, this is considered one stop, meaning that the music supervisor or whoever is looking for music to sync only has to go to one place to get approval to use it. You know, it can be daunting to chase around rights owners, and you can just make your music much more appealing by labeling it as one stop. They know it's going to be easier for them. So that takes us to our next item, which is metadata. Metadata is the information that is embedded into an audio file to identify a handful of things. Things like the artist name, the track name, genre, album artwork, and quite a few other things. Typically, it's going to be MP3s, AIFFs, and FLAC files that have embedded metadata, whereas something like a WAV file only holds very little metadata. Sync Tank has a great blog post that I'll leave in the show notes. That's essentially the metadata standards suggested by the Guild of Music Supervisors. All right, so first piece of metadata, the song name, and it's got some detailed notes here. Like if there's a feature artist, you know, it'll be song title and then in parentheses featuring, you know, whoever that featuring artist is. Next item for song name is that if it's a cover, you know, cite that in the song name field. So like song name and then in parentheses original artist cover. Okay, next up is just the artist name. Pretty self-explanatory. Composer, you know, if this is different from the artist name. In parentheses, you can put the ownership percentage and your performance rights organization number. So if you're like ASCAP or BMI, you can put that number in there. And then, you know, if you own 100% of the rights, you can put 100%. Or, you know, if it's like a collaboration where it's like a 50-50 split, you know, you can just put ownership 50%. Next up is the year. You know, if it was recorded in 2019, put 2019. Genre, it says included if you have it, but not required. Same with BPM. It can be helpful, but not required. Next is, you know, if it's one stop, like we talked about a minute ago, you know, mark it as so. Comments, you can do contact info. So like you can put your email address so that they know who to get a hold of if they want to sync the track. Next up is album. So or just the album name, if it's part of an album or EP or something. Album artist, it's probably going to be the same as the artist, you know, from earlier. Disc number, if it's multiple discs. Track number, you know, if it's multi-track, like an album or an EP, you can put one, two, three, or whatever. And then lastly, artwork. Yeah, like the one-to-one aspect ratio image, you know, whatever the artwork is part of the metadata. All right, moving on. So Music Gateway has a built-in option actually to edit the metadata for each of your audio files. So you'll just click edit metadata and then enter in all the fields that they provide for you. I'd also recommend creating stems for your projects, you know, like separating out your drums, your basses, your leads, just having all separate stems. This is just good practice in general. You know, stems are good for getting out of the creative phase, you know, of the production process and into the mixing and mastering phase. They're good to have for remixes or mashups. And most sync licensing companies will typically ask for them, actually. This allows them to have more freedom and capabilities when it comes to putting your music to, you know, whatever the visual component is. Also, if you have songs with vocals, have an instrumental version on hand. That way they can blend between the two if they need to. Or if there's like dialogue happening while your music's playing, the vocal is not interfering with that dialogue. So back to the platform. Anytime new opportunities become available, you'll get emails with a brief description of what they are looking for, as well as usually what the estimated payout will be. My suggestion would be to only stick with the briefs that you feel, you know, your music would truly fit for. You know, if the clients receive multiple tracks from you that are nowhere near in the ballpark of what they're looking for, they could easily start ignoring your submissions altogether. So I landed this one placement that we're referring to here because I saw an email, you know, stating that they were looking for electronic music for a gaming app. And I felt that, you know, some of my self-released material fit the bill. So a couple months later, you know, after submitting, I received an email saying, congratulations, you know, on the sync placement, and other members of the Music Gateway team will be reaching out to you for like an interview and maybe some other info and so on. One thing that I should probably note here real quick is, you know, while I'm pretty happy with where my production skills are these days, I will say that some of my tracks that got placed in this sync were from my very first EP that I self-released. So the mixes, you know, could have been a lot better. But yeah, I mean, they accepted them. So, you know, just something to note here that, you know, you might not have to have super high level technical skill, you know, with your mixing and everything in order to get a sync placement. Moving on to their pricing, you can sign up for a free account, which, you know, I'd recommend just signing up and seeing, you know, what the platform's like and what kind of opportunities are in there and everything. But yeah, if you do actually want to sign up, you can pay by the month or you can pay by the year. They have three tiers. So the first one is the one that I have, and they call it the Adventurer, and it's £50 per year. So that's right around $64 US a year. And that gives you 500 megabytes. Yeah, the next tier is Influencer, and that is about $192 a year. And that gets you 15 gigs of cloud storage. And then the most expensive tier they have is Game Changer, and that is about $321 a year. And that's for 100 gigs of cloud storage. The thing is, you know, I paid $64 a year and, you know, just one placement, you know, made over $700, you know, after their fees and everything. So, you know, that's with 500 megabytes of cloud storage. So if you have enough music that's going to add up to, you know, several gigs, you know, that's a lot of opportunities that you can have for your music to land sync deals. So it could be worth it. You know, I would start out with the Adventurer one and then just kind of see how it goes and go from there, you know, decide from there. So if you do get a sync placement with them, you will have to create an invoice where you list like your banking information in order for them to wire transfer you to the payment. Personally, I would recommend having a business bank account in place and just reach out to them to get all the details that you'll need for a wire transfer. In my case, you know, I'm in the US and Music Gateway is a UK company. So I had to provide what's called a SWIFT code and my bank's name, the bank's address, my business name and address, and my wire transfer routing number, which it can be different from your regular routing number. Depends on the bank. And then the bank account number. So from there, you can just do like a search for say, Google Doc invoice template. You know, that's all I did. And you can create the invoice that way, unless you have maybe something like FreshBooks, you know, some software that kind of has a invoice system kind of already built into it. So yeah, their team also reached out to get like promo shots and asked, you know, maybe like 8 to 10 interview questions so that they could post up an article on their site, as well as make social media posts, you know, regarding the placement. So, you know, with that, I just recommend making sure that you like retweet, repost, or, you know, make your own social posts once your interview is live on their site. But yeah, I was pretty excited to, you know, that this happened. And I thought it'd be something good for the podcast to share with you guys so that maybe, you know, you can have some success with sync licensing yourself. I guess action items for this episode would be, you know, go to musicgateway.com, sign up for a free account, just kind of scope it out, you know, see how it is, see what the existing opportunities are. If you have music that you've self-released, you know, go ahead and upload a track into their system and get acclimated with the process and the metadata tagging and everything, and maybe check out their FAQ. But yeah, I hope this was helpful. That's it for this time.
Hey guys, it's Felipe from the Producer Evolution Podcast. Just wanted to let you know you can find the show notes for this episode at producerevolution.com/004. And if you like this episode, you can go to producerevolution.com/Apple and leave us a 5-star review. This helps us reach more listeners so we can get better guests for the future. See you next time.
Don't forget to check out Producer Evolution on Facebook and Instagram and at Producer Evo on Twitter. You can find the show notes for this and our other episodes, as well as our courses on producerevolution.com. See you next time.